Thanks for joining us for CBN News Today. I'm Charlene Israel. The president continues to face fierce resistance to his plans for a strike against Syria, both overseas at the G20 summit and at home. World leaders and members of Congress are indicating they have serious concerns. Heather Sells has the latest.
President Obama is returning from the G20 summit without the international support that he wanted.
Mr. President, any progress on Syria today in the talks?
We were talking about the economy this afternoon.
Obama says he wants a strike against Syria to deter it from using chemical weapons in the future, but Russian President Vladimir Putin is opposed. Many believe his views are tied in with the fact that Russia has supplied Syria with arms for years. China is also against a strike. Germany will not take part, nor will Britain, and the European Union is calling for a, quote, political solution. French President Francois Hollande is supporting a strike, although France is divided over the possibility. Back at home, opposition on the Hill is growing, and no one seems to know whether Congress will support the president or not.
My biggest concern is if Assad goes, and there's division within the rebel movement, some of it connected to Al-Qaeda and some of it more moderate, who's going to take over?
There are no good options left in Syria. They're only bad and worse. What I fear the most about Syria is to leave it unattended. It only gets worse over time. 2 years ago, we had some good options. We could have gotten involved with the opposition before Al-Qaeda moved in, and we'd have been on the road, I think, to recovery in Syria. Now we've got just bad options and worse options.
Seven U.S. senators now say they will oppose a resolution on Syria. It's expected to reach the Senate floor next week. Many questions remain, including this: how large will the strike be? ABC News is reporting that the president's national security team is preparing for a significantly larger bombardment than expected. The president, meanwhile, has canceled travel plans for the week and is expected to address the nation to sell his case. Heather Sells, CBN News.
Thanks, Heather. The Obama administration might send U.S. military advisors to train Syrian rebels. Officials say the idea is being discussed at the highest levels. If approved, it would significantly expand a CIA training effort currently taking place in Jordan. Some question the wisdom of directly supporting the rebels. While Secretary of State John Kerry says there are moderates in the ranks, some analysts question that assessment. Here's Chris Mitchell from Jerusalem.
During Secretary of State John Kerry's testimony before the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, he said the Syrian opposition is becoming more moderate.
I would say that Secretary Kerry's testimony does not accurately reflect the reality in the rebel-controlled parts of northern Syria, which I have personally visited.
Middle East analyst Jonathan Speier feels Secretary Kerry's assessment is not only misleading, but potentially dangerous.
I think it's dangerous in the sense that it's creating a rosy and false picture of the situation on the ground in the rebel-controlled part of the country.
Speier says the picture inside Syria's rebel groups is not a pretty one.
Some of these rebel groups are very, very extreme indeed, and for that reason it's become extremely dangerous in recent months for reporters to go in. I'm personally acquainted with at least one journalist who has been kidnapped and is being held in those rebel-controlled areas now. So it's become a very, very dangerous place, full of jihadis, full of criminal elements also, by no means a burgeoning center for democracy, if that's what somebody wants to try to sell here.
Speier says there are three main rebel groups. One is Al-Qaeda.
Then there is a still larger group called the Syrian Islamic Liberation Front. These are the guys who we often hear described as the moderates. These are the people who I think Secretary Kerry and those around him are talking about when they talk about moderates. I've spent some time with one of the important brigades within that, group called the Tawhid Brigade in Aleppo City, and I would not describe them as moderates. I would say these are people from a Muslim Brotherhood type outlook. It doesn't mean they're necessarily organizationally connected to the Brotherhood, but it's that kind of politics, the kind of politics we're familiar with from Hamas around here or from Mursi and the Brotherhood down in Egypt. It's that kind of politics. And I would question very much the description, which we're hearing a lot in the media right now, of those people as moderates. Those people are Islamists, not Al-Qaeda, but Islamists. Mm-hmm.
Congress will soon decide if they believe there are moderates inside Syria they can trust. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Christians in the southern Egyptian town of Dalga are living in fear. Islamist supporters of former President Mohamed Morsi drove out the police and took over the city of 120,000 on July 3rd. Since then, Christian churches, businesses, and homes have been attacked. A Muslim mob set fire to an ancient monastery and stole everything inside. They took icons from a 1,600-year-old chapel and even dug up the remains of Christian saints while looking for buried treasure. There are about 20,000 Christians in Dalga, a city in southern Minya province. Muslim background believers in the North African nation of Morocco are on edge. That after a judge sentenced a former Muslim to 30 months in prison just for becoming a Christian. According to a Christian ministry, a Moroccan newspaper is reporting that Mohammed was accused of telling another person about his Christian faith and having Christian books in his home. He was not allowed to speak with a lawyer or even call his family or friends. The paper said he revealed the names of other Moroccan Christians and foreign believers in other cities, and that the prosecutor has ordered those Christians to be brought in. President Obama has met with the presidents of Mexico and Brazil over the NSA surveillance controversy. They met up at the G20 summit in Russia. The president says the U.S. is working to provide the two countries with information after their two presidents expressed anger. Brazil's Globo TV cited documents leaked by Edward Snowden indicating the NSA monitored the Mexican and Brazilian leaders' communications. The president of Mexico says if the NSA monitored his communications, that would constitute an illegal act. The National Rifle Association has joined a lawsuit against the National Security Agency. The gun owners' lobby filed an amicus brief in a suit against the NSA surveillance program that collects phone records. The NRA says the program essentially is developing a national gun registry, something that Congress has repeatedly rejected. The NRA also warns the surveillance program violates Americans' constitutional right to free speech. The American Civil Liberties Union filed the original suit, and several news organizations have joined in. In San Jose, a federal judge will decide whether Gmail users are victims of invasion of privacy. Google admits to scanning every email sent or received by Gmail's 425 million users. Google says this is included in their privacy policy and terms of service in the fine print.
This is all about Google's business model of gathering as much data as it can about our appetites, our hungers, our desires, so that it can target us with marketing.
At least they should make it clear, like absolutely clear, like bold, fine print, underline 32, italicized, that they're going through my mail.
The case could be pivotal for future Google services. Conservative activists are pushing for Republicans in Congress to stop the funding of Obamacare. Analysts warn it will mean higher prices for health care. Paul Strand has the story.
Conservative critics say most Republican lawmakers refuse to make meaningful moves to strip Obamacare's funding. That's why this rally was held right outside House Majority Leader Eric Cantor's home offices.
He has the majority in the House, and he needs to do that which he pledged to do, which is to defund it.
Soon, the American people will get hit by Obamacare's extremely controversial individual mandate, which will force them to buy health care insurance or pay a penalty. Mike Tanner of the Cato Institute says that mandate will take away competition and lead to higher prices for health insurance.
Just imagine any other product that you're going to buy, whether you're going to buy Twinkies, and you're ordered by the government that you must buy a Twinkie no matter what anyone charges for it. Well, you'd have $100 Twinkies out there. Nothing you could do about it. What forces down prices is consumers saying, hey, that's too expensive, I won't buy it.
Tanner warns Obamacare increasingly puts government in charge of health care, and that's dangerous for America.
More and more decisions are going to be taken away from individual consumers. Now, think of any other goods and services that you buy. If someone else decides what those services are going to be, what those goods are going to be, about quality, about how much you can have, about what they cost, that's not a good recipe. That's what basically made Eastern Europe collapse.
Speakers at this rally pointed out many businesses, unions, and lawmakers themselves are so afraid of Obamacare, they're trying to get exemptions or they've already gotten them.
The presidents of labor unions are saying that this law will shatter their workers' health insurance and destroy the 40-hour work week.
The unions don't want to have anything to do with it. It's such bad news that Eric Cantor and the rest of Congress has exempted itself from it.
If it's not good enough for all these other groups, it's not good enough for the rest of America.
One of the main messages here is that some of the biggest parts of Obamacare are about to kick in, and this is the Republicans' last best chance to defund it. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from Richmond, Virginia.
The City Council of San Antonio has approved changes to its non-discrimination code. The new ordinance includes protections for sexual orientation and gender identity. The measures prohibit council members from discrimination in their official capacity and forbids city workers from refusing to serve customers based on their sexual orientation. But opponents say the ordinance would stifle religious expression and block conservatives from doing business with the city. A petition campaign is underway to recall the 8 council members who voted in favor of the policy.
The people across the city of San Antonio feel like they've been ignored. The majority of people that spoke on this issue opposed this ordinance, and it seems like the city council was not interested in their views.
Christians are especially concerned. The pastor of My Father's House Church in San Antonio said the ordinance will, quote, criminalize us if we speak our faith. And an elder at New Life Christian Center says the gay rights ordinance could prevent him from serving as a city official. Crystal Cathedral founder Robert Schuller has been diagnosed with cancer. The 86-year-old is undergoing treatment for esophageal cancer, which has spread to his lymph nodes. Schuller's daughter made the announcement during a recent sermon. She says her father said he is, quote, ready to go home to be with Jesus. But doctors say with radiation and chemotherapy, the televangelist could live 2 more years. Schuller resigned from the ministry's board in 2012, 2 years after the church filed for bankruptcy. Coming up, The Ultimate Gift and Seasons of Grey, the 2 family-friendly movies you'll want to know about right after this.
Today we're on a field trip to discover what inflation is doing to our paper money. In this hand is a $20 bill, and in this hand is a $20 U.S. gold coin. They used to have the same buying power, but how much can they buy today? And this first basket is what my $20 bill buys. Milk, bread, peanut butter, and jelly. And here's what one $20 gold coin will buy. 6 baskets full, worth nearly $2,000, almost 100 times more food, simply by owning gold dollars instead of paper dollars. History shows that the gold coins have been the best way to beat the rising cost of living. So, class, the moral is that unless you want to live on peanut butter and jelly sandwiches in the future, you should turn some paper dollars into gold coins now. How and why is explained in a new book, The Great Debasement. Call the number below for a totally free copy. And that's the simple truth.
If an emergency happened right now, you can have help at the push of a button with Medical Alert.
Remember when I took that fall, Mary?
Oh, yes, that was terrible.
Yes, it was.
Help!
And I thought, what if you hadn't been there? I ordered my Medical Alert the next day.
I can't describe how safe I feel now with my Medical Alert. You didn't know I was wearing it, did you?
Medical Alert is easy to install, waterproof, and covers you inside your home and out.
It helps me feel safe from fires, break-ins.
And of course, a Medical Alert. And if you don't have a home phone, don't worry. They have that covered.
There's always help at the push of a button. Don't wait till you need it.
Get Medical Alert for less than $1 a day. There are no long-term contracts. Order now and get your second button free. Call for your free brochure.
For your free Medical Alert system with second button free, call 800-575-8507.
Hello? Is this thing on? Hey, kids, do you love games? And do you love discovering things? Yeah! Well, do you? Yeah!
Then you're gonna love this. It's the new free Superbook Kids Bible app. You can play games, watch videos, find answers to your questions, and a whole lot more. The new Superbook Kids Bible app. Free downloads available on iTunes now.
A growing number of Americans are finding a new way to read the Bible on the internet. According to a survey for the American Bible Society by Barna Research, 41% read the Bible on a computer in the last year. 29% searched it on a cell phone, and 17% read it on an e-reader like an iPad or a Kindle. But 85% of those who read the Bible still say they prefer a print version. Former presidential candidate Rick Santorum visited Colorado Springs last night to promote his new movie.
I look at lots of folks in Hollywood who have decided to get involved in politics.
I said, why doesn't someone in politics get involved in Hollywood, particularly a conservative? I really believe that we have an opportunity because the vast majority of this country still believes in the values that made our country great, still believes in the Judeo-Christian principles.
Seasons of Grey is a modern-day Joseph story. It's hitting theaters this month in limited release. Charis Bible College welcomes Santorum to the promotional event. Santorum is CEO of Echo Light Studios, which produced the film. In a bold move from politics to entertainment, Santorum started the company to promote quality-made inspirational films to reach the masses. Well, this weekend is here, and that means it's time for our regular movie reviews. Earlier, we spoke with Bob Waliszewski, director of Plugged In Online, focused on the family's entertainment review department. We asked him about the new film called The Ultimate Life.
I blogged recently. It's a blog called A Few of My Favorite Things, and in that I gave 30 of my favorite movies. One of those was the 2000 film, The Ultimate Gift. Well, The Ultimate Life, which is out today, is both a sequel and a prequel to The Ultimate Gift. The prequel part is that the billionaire who bequeathed his billion-dollar fortune to an heir, we get his backstory. We actually meet him at age 15. We find out he really wasn't as good a guy as he was in the last film, but he became that. But we find that rougher around the edges story of this young man who, even at age 15, wants to be a billionaire. But he'll walk over people. He'll leave his family behind to do so. The sequel part is that the heir who received the billion in the last film has become somewhat of a workaholic. His priorities aren't in place. So he needs a comeuppance moment as well where he can start to put his priorities in place. I gave this film a 4.5 out of 5 for family friendliness. So it's one of those rare times I can say, load the minivan, take your family. And I might add, it's a faith friendly film, not a faith-based film. You won't have an altar call somewhere in the film, but there's several talks about God in very, very respectful ways. I think it's worthy to go, and opening weekend is always the best time to go so we can have a film like this stay around in the theaters a little bit more.
Up next, celebrating the Jewish New Year, what Rosh Hashanah means for Christians.
Attention sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
Welcome back to CBN News Today. This week, Jewish people in Israel and around the world celebrated Rosh Hashanah, the Jewish New Year. That holiday kicks off what's known as the Jewish High Holy Days. Gordon Robertson brings us this story on the significance of Rosh Hashanah and the meaning it holds for Christians.
Rosh Hashanah, the start of the Jewish New Year. Ancient rabbis called it the birthday of the world. Jewish tradition says it's the day that God created man. The Bible calls it the Feast of Trumpets, or Yom Teruah.
If I went home to my Jewish family and said, hey, it's Yom Teruah, they wouldn't even know what I'm talking about. It's called today Rosh Hashanah, which means head of the year. It somehow became the Jewish New Year. Now, how did that happen?
The Feast of Trumpets became the Jewish New Year when the Israelites were exiled in Babylon.
In Babylon, the beginning of the new year was in September. They also had a lunar calendar like the Jewish people, so the first day of the seventh month was the Babylonian New Year. Over time, the Jewish people took the Babylonian New Year and made it our New Year.
And with the New Year come the holiday tradition.
You know, when you talk about Jewish traditions, you're always talking about food. In fact, you can summarize almost every Jewish holiday in the fact that they tried to kill us, God rescued us, let's eat.
People eat pomegranates and pray that their good deeds will be multiplied like the seeds. Round bread shows the cycle of the year. And apples dipped in honey symbolize the desire for a sweet new year.
Another tradition in certain circles of Judaism is to eat a fish head on Rosh Hashanah. I know that sounds yummy, right? But a fish head symbolizes the head of the year, the new year.
The Hebrew greeting is Shana Tova. It's a shorter version of the traditional blessing. May you be inscribed and sealed in the book of life for a good new year.
On the day of Rosh Hashanah, according to Jewish tradition, God has books. And in these books, he decides who has been naughty or nice and who's gonna have a good year and who's gonna have a bad year and who's gonna live and who's gonna die. And so when Jewish people celebrate Rosh Hashanah, they, as a blessing, they're saying, may you be inscribed for a good year. May God bless you. May this go in your favor.
Rosh Hashanah begins a 10-day period known as the Days of Awe.
The 10 days of awe start on Rosh Hashanah and end on Yom Kippur. And during those 10 days of awe, it is believed that you can change your status before God. And so during those 10 days of awe, it is emphasized to pray, tefillah, to give, which is called tzedakah, to do good works, mitzvot, and to repent, tshuvah. Now, the good news for us who believe in Yeshua the Messiah is that our status is the permanent ink of the blood of Yeshua. We don't go into this season wondering whether or not if our name is going to stay in the book or if it's going to get in the book. The day that we come to Yeshua, that we are born from above, our name is put in the book of life forever.
Many Jews observe a ceremony called Tashlik, which means casting off in Hebrew. It's a symbolic way to cast off the sins of the previous year.
The book of Micah speaks of a time when God would cast our sins, the sins of the Jewish people, into the sea. And so Jewish people traditionally on the first day of Rosh Hashanah will take some bread and they will go to a body of water and they will throw the bread into the water as a sign of God taking their sin and casting it into the sea.
The best known tradition is the blowing of the ram's horn, the shofar. Twice the Bible talks about a shofar sounded by God himself. The first time was on Mount Sinai, as the Israelites prepared to enter their covenant with God. The second time will be at the return of the Messiah.
I believe that was God's original intent when he gave this special time to Moses, a time of blowing trumpets, blasting trumpets, to look to the final trumpet that'll be sounded when Yeshua appears in the sky.
Cantor says this Jewish holiday can also be a celebration for Christians.
So then the question is, how can Christians celebrate along with Jewish people Rosh Hashanah? I think first of all, they can fast and they can pray and they can, during these 10 days of awe, can be a time of believing God for revival within Israel, within the Jewish world. It can be a time of intercession for the Jewish people to know their Messiah. I think also a great way to celebrate this holiday is to look to the coming of Yeshua. I think it's a time for Christians and Messianic Jews to look to heaven and say, come, Yeshua, come. We long for your returning.
When you're driving along and your cell phone rings, do your eyes instantly go off the road? Then you need to get a grip. Hi, David Jones here with the new GripGo, the most versatile hands-free mount that will instantly grip any phone for safe driving. Just attach the suction cup to your windshield or dash, and GripGo grabs your phone ultra fast. Then it peels right off. And don't worry, there's no sticky residue left behind. The 360-degree pivoting mount allows you to always get the perfect viewing angle. It's even strong enough to grab and hold this expensive smartphone out the window, yet it comes right off with ease. That's the advantage of GripGo. You can get the amazing GripGo with dashboard mount for only $14.95. We'll send you a second kit free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Get two complete GripGo systems for just $14.95.
To order GripGo for $14.95 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-709-5259 or order online at getgripgo.com.
Jim is 38, mortgage, married, three great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. Jim can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $19 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll comparison shop the pick of insurance companies like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. Jim's wife, Deidre, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote. We shop, you save.
Finally today, CBN staff stepped in to help after a recent natural disaster in China. An earthquake devastated homes in the rural province of Gansu. CBN worked with local churches providing food and supplies to more than 200 households. So far this year, CBN has responded to 22 natural disasters in six countries. Way to go, CBN. Well, that's it for now on CBN News Today. You can find more of our exclusive coverage of the issues you care most about at cbnnews.com. And tell us what you think about the stories you've seen today. You can do that on Facebook or at CBN News on Twitter. We hope you'll join us next time. Have a great day. God bless.
If you had a choice between going bald and a full head of hair, which would you choose? Advances in medical science have resulted in the world's first and only permanent solution to hair loss.
Yes!
You wash it, you cut it. It's your own real, naturally growing hair. When it comes to hair restoration, no one in the world has more experience than Bosley. The results look completely natural and are affordable on nearly any budget. But the entire process can't be explained in 60 brief seconds. So to find out more about this clinically proven and permanent solution to hair loss, call now to receive your free, no obligation information kit. It'll answer all of your questions about hair loss and hair restoration. Plus, we'll also send you this $250 gift certificate just for calling. Every day you wait, you're losing more hair. So don't put it off any longer. You owe it to yourself to find out the facts. Choose hair. Choose Bosley.
Call 800-868-9957. That's 800-868-9957.
Introducing the CBN Bible from CBN.com. Now, an easier way to study the Bible and grow in your faith. Highlight your favorite verse. Read separate versions at a glance. Click and read a commentary. Or cross-reference your favorite verse using the Strong's Concordance. All the right tools to study the Bible, all in one place. the CBN Bible, available at cbn.com/Bible or the iTunes App Store.